Good morning to all of you. Yesterday we studied about single tone and multi tone modulation technique of AM signals, of where their time domain, Fourier transform, all the frequency signals and their calculations. Today we study about the power relations in AM waves. Here in my slide you can see that today we are calculating the first we calculate the power of AM waves. As we know, consider the expression for the single tone or sinusoidal AM wave. Here this is AC is the center amplitude, cos of 2 pi FCT 1 by 2, and AC cos of 2 pi FC plus FM, this so on. This is increasing the frequency. This expression contains the three components. First three components, they are carrier components, and then upper sidebands, lower sidebands. Therefore, the average power of the AM wave is sum of these components, because each and every signal having a center frequency to a carrier frequency, then upper sideband and lower sideband. So we are trying to calculate the power of that carrier signal and carrier signal, upper sideband and lower sideband. So the total power of amplitude modulated wave will be V carrier signal square by R. R is the resistance. V lower sideband square by divided by R plus voltage of upper sideband square by divided by R, where all the voltages are in RMS values and R is the resistance. Here the PC is the power of carrier voltage, is V carrier of square divided by R. We can write it as a amplitude of carrier signal divided by root 2 of whole square by R. This will by this we can also write a power of lower sideband. This will be M square by 4 into PC. And upper sideband will be M square by 4 into PC. This is the values of power of carrier signal, lower sideband, upper sidebands. So the total power will be the sum of these, power of carrier signal, power of lower sideband, power of upper sideband. So PT will be PC plus M square by 4. This calculation will be calculated. This. So by calculating these things, we will get PT is equals to PC 1 plus M square by 2. This is the total power of any signal. The ratio of the total sideband power to that total power is modulated wave is given by this P by PT, total power by PT sidebands. Then it is PC into M square by 2 divided by this value, so total power. Then the power of sideband divided by total power is equals to M square by 2 plus M square. This is called as efficiency of AM wave. Now we will discuss about the generation of AM waves. Then the generation of AM waves. Two basic amplitude modulation principles are we will discuss. First is square law modulator and switching modulator. For any output device, is not directly proportional to input throughout. So for this operation, we say it's a non-linear. So input-output relation of a non-linear device is, can be expressed as this. It is output V0 is equals to A0 plus A1 V1 plus A2 V2 V in plus A2 V in square plus A3 V in. It is the amplitude of next waves. The voltage is the same. So when the input is very small, the higher power of terms will be negated, because due to the higher terms, square, 4, 6, up to 4th square, we are using up to 4 power. After that, the signal voltage harmonics will be generated, and it will, due to that, the changes in the value of output is approximately negligible. So we can neglect it. That's why we are using up to 3 or 4 power voltage signals. So approximately given by V0 is equals to A0 plus A1 V in plus A2 V in square. When the output is considered up to square of inputs, the device is called square law devices. So the figure will show the square law modulator. Here we can see that it is an input message signal M of T. It is a carrier signal AC cos of 2 pi FCT. It is any nonlinear device. It is a tuned circuit of any frequency FC, center frequency. It is voltage, input voltage V1 of T, it is output voltage of V2 of T. So total functioning of this square law modulator will depends on the voltages. So here we consider that it is a central carrier frequency. It is ACT is equal to AC cos of 2 pi FCT. And information is M of T. It is fed simultaneously in the figure. So V in is equal to CT plus M of T. It means combination of this V1 of input voltage. So AC cos of 2 pi FCT plus MT. As the level of the input is very small, the output can be considered up to the square values. So output will be V0 is equal to A0 plus A1 V in plus A2 V square. So V0 is equal to A0, A1 AC cos of 2 pi FCT plus M of T, A2 equals this. We are putting the values of V in. By calculating these expanding these equations, we get this value. This is the value. Now, taking the Fourier transform of this, we will get this value A0 plus A0 AC square by 2 delta of F. This is the Fourier transform equation of this. Therefore, the square law device output 0 volt consists of the DC components. If components at F is equal to 0, frequency is 0, the output will be 0. The information signal ranging from 0 to W hertz, any frequency where you want to calculate. And its harmonics are signal at FC and 2FC. So frequency band centered at frequency FC and deviation of plus minus W hertz. It is maybe FC plus W, FC minus W. So the required AM signal with the carrier signal FC can be separated using a band pass filter at the output of the square law device. And the filter should have a lower cutoff frequency ranging between 2W at end FC minus W, and upper cutoff frequency will be FC plus W and 2FC. Therefore, the output, filter output, this is a filter. I will show you the figure first. This is a output. Here we get the output signal. So it is a signal with a filter output. So the output will be S of T A1 AC cos of 2 pi FCT plus 2 A2 AC 2 M2. By this, we will first take the common A1 and AC. AC is common, A1 is common. Then the equation will be AC A1 AC 1 plus 2 A2 by A1 M of T cos of 2 pi FCT. When M of T is equal to A M into cos of 2 pi F in T. When you calculate, we put this value A in, S of T A1 of AC 1 plus 2 A in cos of 2 pi F in cos of 2 pi FCT. Comparing with this with the standard signal, it is AC 1 plus K MT of cos of 2 pi. Therefore, the M is 2 A2 by A1 A in. The output AM signal is free from distortion and attenuation only when FC minus FW is greater than 2W or FC is greater than 3W. The spectrum is being shown again. Now, the second is switching modulator. For switching modulator, we are considering we are using a diode for the signal generation. So for any ideal switch which the carrier signal is this and information is, so we are considering that it's a diode is an ideal switch. It means it may be on or off, no other conditions. So it is known as an ideal switch. Now the input will be again V1 is equals to carrier signal plus message signal is M of T, this is AC cos of 2 pi FCT MT. Now the peak amplitude of CT is maintained more than that of the information signal operator is assumed to be dependent on the carrier signal as irrespective to the message signal. So first we consider the positive half. It means when V2 and V1, the outside voltage and input side voltage will be same, then the diode will be forward bias. If output voltage is zero, it means the diode will be in the reverse bias. So by depending on this, the operation will be held and the output will be received. So the PT is equal to 1 by 2, this 1 plus 1 upon pi summation of n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, minus 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2n minus 1 cos of 2 pi FCT t into 2n minus 1. So for n is equals to 0 and 1, because we are considering two points only, up to the square a0 plus a1 plus a2, a square, and n is equals to 0 or 1. So this will be, we will get the this equation. Pt is equal to 1 by 2, 1 upon pi cos of 2 pi fct minus 2 upon 3 pi cos of 6 pi fct plus this. Therefore, the diode response is a product of switching response of power and voltage. And V2 is equals to V1 into P. V2 is equals to V1 and P. We can put the value, applying Fourier transform, and we will get this equation. So the output, diode output V2 is consist of DC component. Therefore, the signal ranging from 0 to W hertz, an infinite number of frequency bands centered at F1, 2FC, 3FC, 4FC. The required AM signal carried at FC frequency can be separated using a band pass filter. The lower cutoff frequency for the band pass filter should be between W and FC minus W, and for upper sideband it will be FC plus W to twice of FC center frequency. The filter output is given by any equation. This is the equation AC by 2, 1 plus 4 MT pi AC cos of 2 pi. For single tone information, let MT is equals to AM cos of 2 pi FMT, then S of T is equals to AC by 2, 1 plus 4 upon pi AM by AC cos of 2 pi FMT cos of 2 pi FCT. Therefore, modulation index is equals to 4 by pi AM by AC. The output of AM is free from the distortion and attenuations only when FC is minus W is greater than W or FC is greater than twice of W. Now, the detection of AM signal. Right now, we have generated the AM signal. Now, we have to demodulate the AM signal. So, by demodulation, we will recover the message signal. Let's say M of T, baseband signal, or we can say it's a baseband signal. Message signal is also known as an information signal, baseband signal. Okay, we have to recover it from that carrier signal. So, we will use some methods for detection of it. The mainly two methods will be used, that is square layer detector and envelope detector. Okay, first we consider about the square layer detector. Consider a non-linear device which is the AM signal S of T is applied when the level of S of T is very small output and can be considered up to square of that input. It means S of T signal non-linear, V of T low pass filter, and we will get the M of T. So therefore, A0 is equal to A1 V in plus A2 V in square. The M of T is the signal 0 to W hertz, and carrier signal will be AC cos of 2 pi of T. So S of T, the input signal AM is non-linear device given by this. This is, we calculated this previously. So to recover it, we put this value in S of T. That is V0 is equal to, it is the output value. V0 plus A0 plus A1 S of T plus A2 ST of square. Now we put the value of S of T. Now we will see the figure. Now taking the Fourier transform of both sides, applying Fourier transform, and we will get the equation of this K, AC, KM, M of F, FC plus FM. It means the FC minus F minus FC, F plus FC, upper side and lower side with the signal. The device output consists of a DC component and F is equal to 0. Therefore, the information ranging from 0 to W hertz and second harmonics and frequency band centered at the frequency FC and 2FC. Now, we have to design a low pass filter of a range between W hertz to FC minus W. So, in this equation, the signal which is having a frequency in between W and FC minus W will be passed and other frequencies signal will be bypassed. So the filter output will be this A0 plus A2 AC square by 2 plus A2 AC square KA M of T plus A2 AC square KA square M square of T by 2. That is, if we see this equation, it shows a DC component, message signal, and second harmonic. This is a message signal, and here the signal is squared. That's why it's a harmonic, second harmonic signal, and it's a DC component. So what we need, we need this message signal.